Hi and assalamu alaikum to our lecturer Dr. Muhammad Rizwan Abdul Aziz and to my fellow friends. Welcome to our video. So today my team going to present about the issues, opportunities and challenge of Awanu. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Let's go.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Yusuf bin Azmi. Pawnbroking is a form of financing that has long existed in Malaysia and is even said to have existed since the heyday of Greek and Roman civilization. One of the earliest in mobilizing Awanu scheme was Majlis Agama Islam dan Adat Melayu Terengganu, MAIDAM, where on 23 January 1992, they introduced Muassasah Gadaian Islam Terengganu. After that, efforts to expand Awanu were continued by several Islam institutions such as Perbadanan Kemajuan Iktisad Negeri Kelantan through its subsidiary Permodalan Kelantan Berhad. A year later, Awanu continued to be developed through cooperation between three parties, namely Yayasan Pembangunan Ekonomi Islam Malaysia, YAPIM, Bank Negara Malaysia and Bank Kerjasama Rakyat Malaysia Berhad. In 1997, YAPIM once again collaborated with other institutions where this time they chose Bank Islam, BIMB. In 2002, YAPIM through the Counters of Kooperasi YAPIM Berhad has arranged their own Awanu scheme and has benefited over 800,000 of their customers. In line with the changes of the times and the development of knowledge, the implementation of Awanu is likely to improve and change in several aspects. Therefore, in this assignment, we list and elaborate some of the issues, opportunities and challenges in implementing this scheme.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Ghaziq bin Burhanuddin. So today I'm going to talk about the issues of Awanu. The first issue of Awanu is the debtor failed to repay his debt at maturity. This is the common issue not in Malaysia but around the world. And some of pledger refused to pledge or creditor to sell their pledged property. So this is tough for Awanu provider to get back their money. And the hardest one is when the actual pledger is dead and their ancestor didn't know about the contract of Wahan that the actual pledger met from the Awanu provider. Next, the second issue of Awanu is lack of technologies in determining the originality of Mahut. The technology that used by Awanu provider is nowadays is quite obsolete because of time consuming and non-detection on fake gold. Now, fake gold can be made with molten lead that have been mixed with tungsten and plated with gold leaf or titanium. The third issue is the governance of Awanu lack legal act and jurisdiction. For conventional pawn shop, we have Pawn Shop Act 1972. Therefore, there is no law or act found to protect the transaction on behalf of pledger and pledgee of Awanu. For Pawn Shop Act 1972, the act is contrary to Sharia principle, which is Pawn Shop Act 1972 content of riba. This act is fact never cover the practice of Awanu as prescribed by the Sharia law. Next issue is misconception of Awanu by the community. The community in Malaysia always misunderstood about the purpose of Awanu. The actual purpose of Awanu to give microfinancing to everyone. And for the rich community, they thought Awanu is for the poor people that need money. And for the poor community, they thought the margin of Awanu are low compared to other financial institutions. But this conception is wrong. And because of poor community need more money, so they prefer to take money from moneylender, loan shark or conventional bank that have interest. And after that, they have been chased by the loan shark. So the last issue is all need to go online. We have 32.37 million population in Malaysia in 2020 based on World Bank statistic. And from Statista, we have 63% of Malaysian use internet online banking in 2020. This is a great opportunity for Awanu provider to go online because it is more easy and convenient. And customer only walk into the store for process of Awanu like to confirm the originality of Mahun. That's all for me. Thank you.
For the opportunities, banks must strive to increase competitive advantage in order to gain larger market share such as increasing promotion, socializing about Sharia banking understanding and striving to improve service quality for customers. Malaysian population is growing, so it has potential to become the potential market for the mining of Sharia bank in Malaysia branches. In order to gain a larger customer market share, a precise promotional strategy is required. The demand for Islamic pawnbroking service has been steadily increased since their introduction. Customers prefer Islamic pawnbroking service to traditional pawnbroking service because the former offer quick, hassle-free, reward-free and transparent microcredit facilities. As the catalyst for further growth of Islamic pawnbroking in Malaysia, operators must take aggressive measures, particularly in terms of raising awareness among prospective customers. The operators, the pawnbroker, should take steps to disseminate information about their operation principle and scheme via media brochure and online facts. Malaysia has excellent opportunity and expertise to expand Islamic pawnbroking business in this region. The government should encourage those in desperate need to flush cash approach Islamic pawnbroker rather than illegal money lender who charge exorbitant interest rate and use unfair collection practices. Another opportunity is the effort to upgrade existing product of Arahnu. The process is not intended to replace the existing product but rather to provide consumer with a broader range of options for engaging the mechanism of financing from the debt-based contract. The existence of Arahnu product will be improved when it potential is fully realized and it eventually become a viable alternative product in the financial markets.
The first challenge is strong competition from conventional pawnbroking. Because customers can get up to 90% of margin value in conventional pawnbroking, while in Arahnu only up to 65%, making it much more preferable for the customers to pawn their assets in the conventional pawnbroking. Secondly, is people's mindset, where most of the people think that Arahnu is only to help those who are poor. But the truth is, Islamic pawnbroking or Arahnu also provides services same as conventional pawnbroking. Thirdly, is fake gold. There are a lot of cases where customers pawn fake gold in the Arahnu and making it questionable to the customers about the security system in the Islamic pawnbroking. Next is lack in rural area. Rural area is the area outside the city. People that live in rural area cannot find Arahnu because it is hard to find. But it is easy to find conventional pawnbroking outside the city. So people have more knowledge about conventional pawnbroking compared to Islamic pawnbroking. Advertisements are also one of the challenges faced by Arahnu. Advertisement made by the conventional pawnbroking can easily be found in every platform, radio, television or any social media platform. But it is hard to find advertisement about Islamic pawnbroking. So this is the reason why people cannot find any information about Arahnu. Lastly is lack of monitoring in terms of the ownership of the assets. There are a few cases where robbers steal the gold and pawn it at Arahnu without any problem. So this raised doubtful among the customers about the Islamic financial system.
In conclusion, we can say that Arahnu offers numerous benefits over the traditional mortgage system and has so far attracted the attention of various segments of Malaysian society. To ensure that all members of society may profit from the Islamic system, however, it should not be restricted to just a few groups but should be made available to everyone.